Hello friends, welcome back to my new lecture. Today we are going to see the information related to solar water heater. This is simple kind of solar water heater which is most widely used at our home. Let us see its construction and working. So construction, there are two major parts in this particular solar water heater. First part is called as solar collector, next part is called as water tank. And this solar collector and water tank, they are connected with each other by using various pipelines. Let's see what is solar collector. This is a solar collector which is faced towards sun. So if sun rays are coming like this, it's necessary the face of solar collector should be towards a sun. In the solar collector, we are having a number of tubes which are circulated here, and above this particular tube, what we are having is transparent glass. This tube has an inlet pipeline which is coming from a bottom like this, and it has an exit pipeline from this. The exit pipeline is going to the water tank. At the same time, inlet pipeline is coming from a water tank. This solar collector will collect heat from the sun. This is first part solar collector. Next part is called as water tank. Basically, water tank has a four pipe connection. First pipe connection is this one, which is coming from a solar collector like this. Second pipeline is going towards a collector. These are two connected to the solar collector, whereas these two are coming from an outside. The cold water will be coming inside to water tank with this particular pipeline, whereas the hot water will be taken from this. So whatever the objective of this solar water heater is there, to get a hot water. So hot water will be available through this particular pipeline. The green color shows an insulation which is provided on the water tank. Insulation will avoid a loss of heat to the atmosphere. Okay, now this was about the construction. Now let's go for working. For the working, when the sun rays are coming from a sun, this animation is shown. Sun rays are coming from sun and it is falling on the tubes. So inside a tube, what we are having is the water. So water will get heated because of the heat coming from a sun. Here we have shown that the blue color will show the cold water, whereas the orange color will show a hot water. You will see that on the upper part we are having heated water, whereas lower part we are having a cold water which is coming from the water tank. Now once water will get heated because of the sun's heat, this water will become lighter. Why it will become lighter? Because its density will get reduced, and as the density get reduced, the water become lighter and it will try to move on upward side direction. So here what we have done is water tank provided on a higher height, whereas the collector is provided on a lower height. So if water gets heated in the solar collector, it becomes lighter and it will try to move on upward side through this particular pipeline. That pipeline we have written name here as a hot water. So we can see here that the movement of water will be like this. As becomes lighter, it will be moving like this and it will be deposited in the water tank. So upper part of this particular tank will be occupied by hot water and lower part will be occupied by the cold water which is coming from outside pipeline. Generally the cold water has a higher density, whereas hot water is having less density, and that's why hot water is on the upper side. So as a hot water is entering on this side, the volume of this water tank is constant. So some water has to be taken outside, so that water is nothing but a cold water. The cold water will be going like this and it will be entering into the solar collector. So cold water is moving like this and hot water is moving upwards. So this total movement of water is because of the density difference. As the density of hot water is less, it is moving up. As the density of cold water is more, it is moving downside. So because of density difference, the water is moving. So we have not provided any external device like pump or any other devices. This such kind of solar water heater is called as thermosiphon solar water heater. Thermosiphon means what? Because of temperature, the water is moving, and that's why it is called a thermosiphon solar water heater system. So this is cycle completed. Water is coming from this and again water is going to the collector. On this side we can take out a hot water from this one. So for the application like bathing etc, we can take a hot water from this, and if water is going outside, the cold water is also coming inside from this one. So cold water will enter here and hot water will going outside. The cold water which has entered here, that will go to the solar collector like this, and from solar collector hot water will be coming here and that hot water will be going out. This is what cycle and the working of thermosiphon solar water heater system. Sometime this circulation of water rate is not sufficient. At that time we have to provide a pump like I will fit a pump here. So if I provided a pump here, then what will happen? The pump will suck the water from this side and it will supply the water on this one. So pump will increase the rate of circulation of water, and that's why we can have more flow of the water and more flow of the water at the outlet of this particular water tank. Okay, so if pump is provided, then it's called as active solar water heater. And if pump is not provided, so without pump if it is working, then it is called as thermosiphon water heater system. Thank you very much for listening.